I, Porichoy Patro of IIT Jodhpur, Department of Humanities, also a member of the DH group. I'm conducting this interview, something like an interview with Professor Ganguly. Now, before proceeding to the DH and other discussions that we have for today, I would like to introduce Professor Ganguly to you, who doesn't really need an introduction amongst these circles. So Professor Ganguly is very well known, not only as a research scientist, but also as one of the leading IP rights experts in our country. He is the founder of Vision IPR in Mumbai, and he is currently working as the advisor for that. Along with that, Professor, apart from being a leading patent attorney, Professor Ganguly is associated with several institutions as IP rights and patent experts, especially with IIT Kharagpur and IIT Jodhpur, the institution that I'm from. And he organizes, conducts several workshops across the nation and abroad regarding IP rights. He has many publications on IP to his credit. So when we proposed an MSc in Digital Humanities in IIT Jodhpur, we organized an expert workshop on it, where we had Professor Ganguly amongst us. So today, I'll have a brief conversation with Professor Ganguly. I'll just ask him a few questions on IP and its association with digital humanities, its relevance and other stuff, which might be interesting for those of you who are considering a career in the field in digital humanities. So we are going to start the interview. Hello, Professor Ganguly.
Hello, how are you?
Good, thank you so much. How are you going?
Good.
So let's start the interview for our listeners, our students who are interested in this. So my first question is this: what is intellectual property and how does it matter in the humanities?
Intellectual property is something that is inseparable from our lives. The reason I say so is because the entire human race is all the time innovating. And why? Because it wants to sustain itself. And for sustenance, you need to innovate. You need to address issues that you're facing, that or issues that you may face. And therefore, all the creative elements of the human mind come into action. You try and meet unmet needs. So the way in which you create, you innovate, you then come to the market, you then place it before society. Therefore, society and sustainability of society is only possible when we innovate. That's the first part. Therefore, creations of the human mind is an essential part or part and parcel of ourselves. Then comes in the next point, that having done innovations, having developed knowledge, I would like to share my knowledge with others, because knowledge grows only by sharing. But the question that comes about is that, can I share this knowledge fearlessly in society? Do I have the fear that people will copy me and not give me a due recognition or due returns? Now, in that sense, society, and therefore the government, have actually created a system of intellectual property rights where the creators of knowledge can get protected for the knowledge they create, and in turn, they service society and get something in return. So the question is that it is some sort of a quid pro quo, that you give to society and society gives you donations by way of what is known as intellectual property rights. So when you do this, it's a fair balance. It's a system of balance. Say that, well, if you have created something, please share it as fearlessly as possible, because the society has created a framework of intellectual property rights which will protect you as well. So this is a very basic, in a very simplistic manner, that I can bring what is intellectual property rights.
And as I mentioned with the second part of my question, how or why does it matter in the humanities?
Yes.
What is your opinion on that?
Very important. The whole concept of humanities, as the word says, it deals with human societies. So humanities is nothing else but dynamics of human society. So when you come to the dynamics of human society, the facts are there and that they are constantly innovating. Therefore, since the framework of intellectual property rights gives you that confidence that you can share without fear of your rights getting lost. So it's very important. On one side, the society, the law, gives you a monopoly, right? It gives you a monopoly, but very interesting, for it to be useful in society, it discourages you being monopolistic. So you enjoy your monopoly, but you should not become monopolistic. Now there's a big difference between enjoying monopoly and becoming monopolistic. So therefore, what you do is you enjoy a monopoly, you share, but you get a fair benefit. You know, it's a fair benefit return that you get, and you give enough to society. So in case of, you know, for example, let's take a few examples. For example, suppose in healthcare, I create something. Society needs healthcare for sustainability. So I give to society by way of my creation in the field of healthcare. Society ensures that I get sufficient return, therefore I continue to be sustainable and society gains in this particular way. Similarly, because of intellectual property rights, it gives us a way of collaborating. So if somebody else is also creating, then I can share with that person can share with me. So we go into some sort of a synergistic collaboration, a symbiotic collaboration, which is very important for the sustenance of society. Similarly, so if you look at climate change, you look at any small inventions, or even suppose people develop, you know, or create new, let us say, business models, right? Or if you look at different ways of healthcare, you look at different ways in which people, let's say, develop different motor cars, different types of concept of travel. All these are things which are important for society. And therefore, intellectual property rights, because it gets intertwined with all these, becomes inseparable from societal dynamics. Therefore, the study of intellectual property rights and the balancing of rights and responsibilities are become an essential factor, and this is something that is very important for a state.
Thank you, Professor. So my next question is, would you like to offer your comments on observations on intellectual property in the digital age? How does that matter? Why is it so significant?
Very important. This is one of the most important aspects in our lives today. The digital technology, you know, has got so strongly mixed with our lives that we can't believe that little assistance. Now, what has happened? Because of digital processes, digital technologies, first of all, creation and recording of creations has become easy. Communication of these things has also become much easier than it was in the past. With all this, reproduction has also become easier. Copying has also become easier. So digital processes have actually aided several aspects, but it also brings in a major challenges in terms of how do you sort of retain their contents to the whatever they've created, and whatever has gone into digital media, it can get distributed so easily. Now, that is on one side, but that's something that can be controlled by law. Important part is how do we use all these digital techniques, digital methods, digital methodologies out there, A, to create, to enhance our own creativity, to create better products so that we are able to service the society in a better way. Similarly, the digital methods or digital techniques should be used by society also to very effectively exploit, if I may use, or for benefits in society. The digital processes not only brings benefit, it also brings some concerns, obviously. But if you are able to overcome those concerns in a rightful way, this is only here to stay. And therefore, combining digital processes together with processes in intellectual property rights, together with processes in innovations, together with all the dynamical processes in society is going to play a very important role. And in my opinion, digital humanities is all about these processes. And therefore, we need to look at humanities not only from the point of view of interaction between humans, but how do we use digital media for the best use and best purposes for a sustained human society.
Thank you so much, sir. Now, would you like to comment on, this is my last question for the day. Would you like to comment on, say, the future of IP and why one needs to be equipped with the knowledge?
This is a very significant question. What is the future of IP? As I said, right in the beginning, all forms of intellectual property by law gives the creator a monopoly. Now, monopoly is like having a right to stop others. But the question is that if we want to stay and we want to sustain in society, should we overuse our monopoly? So we have to use that monopoly in a very balanced manner. Therefore, we have to balance between use of the monopoly and try and prevent the overuse of the monopoly. So the future is going to be to make it most effective. Collaborations are going to be very important. Working together is going to be very important. Cooperative processes are going to be very important. And when we cooperate, when we work together, when we want to synergize, when we want to, you know, get into those processes, you know, where we want to really make the best of a societal togetherness, very important part in intellectual property rights will be what I call as the fair benefit sharing between the different stakeholders. Now, intellectual property rights will take a new dimension where this element of cooperative working will play a very important role, point number one. Point number two, because cost is going to be a major factor, therefore, accessibility of the creations at affordable prices is going to be a very important aspect. And therefore, putting all these things together, the dimensions of intellectual property rights, apart from the elements of law, we will have to bring in both inseparable parts of the societal dynamics into it to ensure that there is the best mode for cooperative working for the benefit of one and all, but all at affordable prices and making it as accessible as possible in the most inclusive manner. That's the future of intellectual property rights. And that is how intellectual property rights service humanities and digital humanities is going to play a very important role.
Thank you so much, Professor, for joining us, for engaging with the queries that we had. And I'd like to thank everyone, all of you who are listening to this, and those, I mean, digital humanities career aspirants. These words will be very, really very valuable and beneficial for you, I hope. Thank you.
Thank you very much as well.